What is time? Well, time has been a subject of debate for millennia. Some thinkers argue that time is an illusion, while others consider it as a fundamental part of reality.
Earlier, the Western concept was that time is linear and absolute.
But relativity shows that time is not absolute. It can be stretched or compressed depending on factors like velocity and gravity. Physicists define time as the progression of events from the past to the present into the future. Now here in this definition, we find a very important word, event. Now if we ask what an event is, then what? What will be the answer? We can say something that happens.
Do you think this is the perfect answer?
Maybe it's not complete. An event is something that occurs in a certain place during a particular interval of time. So you can see, events and time are interlinked. Generally, time is a space between two events. So, to calculate time or measure time, you need to witness at least two events. Only then, we will be able to find the duration between them. And that's how we can calculate time. For thousands of years, time has been measured using the length of the solar day. This is the interval between two successive returns of the sun to an observer's local meridian. Unfortunately, the length of the apparent solar day varies over a year. In many modern Western scientific calculations, you will find that they use light speed as a crucial ingredient. Also, you will find that in the most current definition of second, they use atom. Interestingly, in ancient Indian exploration of time, they also used sunlight and atom, but in different ways. Here in this video, we will show you how time was calculated in ancient India. According to Bhagavata Purana,
the smallest indivisible particle of material substance, which remains in its unevolved state and has not yet combined with other similar particles, is eternal in its causal form and is referred to as the Paramanu.
Two Paramanus make one Anu, with three Anus constitute a Trasarenu, seen floating in space through the sunlight that enters a room through the eye holes of a lattice. In modern English, we translate Anu as a molecule and Paramanu as an atom. Here in this sloka, you can see it is said three Anus make a Trasarenu, which is visible. But in reality, even the combination of 100 molecules is not visible to our naked eyes. So, we have to understand that the understandings of Anu or molecules in the past and present differ in size. Another important thing, the size of atoms and molecules also differs from element to element and compound to compound. But we must acknowledge and appreciate the calculation process of ancient Indian scholars, which is still very relevant. Now let's see how they are calculating time using these. The measure of time taken by sunlight to cross a composite of three Trasarenu is known as Truti. 100 Trutis make a Ved, while three Vedas constitute what is known as a Lava, a composite of three Lavas known by the name of Nimesh, or twinkling of an eye. Three Nimeshas make one Shana, or moment. A composite of five Shana is known as a Kashta, while 15 Kashtas go to make a Laghu. 15 Laghus taken together are called a Nadika. A couple of Nadikas constitute one Muhurta, while 6 or 7 Nadikas, as per the day or night is short or long, make one Prahar, which forms 1/4 of a day or night of human beings. Here you have to understand, in terms of ancient Indian concept, day means sunrise to sunset. Day and night together called Ahoratra. Nadika is also known as Yama. The day and night of human beings consist of 4 Yamas or quarters each. Ahoratra, which is equal to 8 Prahar. 15 Ahoratra constitute a Paksha or fortnight, which is bright and dark alternatively. In Indian context, we call it Krishna Paksha and Shukla Paksha. Both these pakshas taken together make one mass or month, which is equal to an Aharatra of the Pitras. 2 months taken together go to make a Ritu or season, while an Ayan consists of 6 months. And Ayana is southerly and northerly by turns, as sun takes a southerly or northerly course. We call it Uttarayan and Dakshinayan. And the two Ayans constitute an Aharatra of the gods in heaven. These are known as one Vatsar or year, which is 12 months on earth. Here, one important thing is, in the ancient Indian concept, a year is of 360 days, not 365. Now you may ask, why this mismatch?
Because these ancient Indian texts relied on the lunar cycle to define months and days, while it is the solar cycle which determines the complete year. This approach posed the challenge of reconciling the approximately 354 lunar days in 12 months with the over 365 solar days in a year. To address this discrepancy, they developed various systems, the most prominent of which was the use of intercalary months, adding an extra month approximately every 32.5 months.
These calendars were further refined during the Gupta era of astronomy by Aryabhatta and Varahamihir in the 5th to 6th century. We will talk about it in another video. Here, in this video, our focus is mainly on the Puranas, especially Bhagavata Purana. So, let's get back to our main topic. 100 years have been declared as the full lifespan of human beings. This calculation of one Vatsar or year is for humans, which is equal to one full day of Devas or gods. So, one divine year is equal to 360 human year. Now, this is not the end of the calculation. In Vedic times of ancient India, time is viewed as cyclical and is divided into 4 different yugas or ages. Just like the seasons, the 4 ages or Chatur Yuga rotate one after another without end. The names of the 4 yugas are Satya or Krita, Treta, Dwapar and Kali. The durations of these yugas in divine years are 4000, 3000, 2000 and 1000 respectively. Now each yuga also has extra buffer periods at the beginning and end. These portions are called Sandhya and Sandhyangsha. For Satya Yuga, it is 400 divine years for each. Similarly for Treta, it is 300 each. For Dwapar, the duration of Sandhya and Sandhyarsha, 200 each. Lastly, for Kali, it's 100 each. So, the total duration of Satya Yuga is 4800 divine years. The total duration of Treta Yuga is 3600 divine years. The total duration of Dwapar is 2400 divine years. The total duration of Kali Yuga is 1200 divine years. These 4 yugas are combinedly called Mahayuga. So the duration of Mahayuga is 4800 plus 3600 plus 2400 plus 1200, which is equals to 12,000 divine years or celestial years. Now as we said earlier, one divine year is equals to 360 human years. So in that sense, Satya Yuga is 1,728,000 human years. Treta Yuga, 1,296,000 human years. Dwapar Yuga, 864,000 human years. And Kali Yuga is 432,000 human years. So the duration of Mahayuga is 4,320,000 human years. 1,000 revolutions of the Mahayugas constitute a day of Brahma, and equal in that length is the night, when Brahma, the creator of the universe, goes to sleep, withdrawing all the 3 worlds into his belly. At the close of night, the creation of the three worlds commences, as in the preceding Kalpa, and continues for the lifelong day of Brahma, which embraces the regime of the 14 Manus. Each Manu holds the power of the period allotted to him, which is little over 71 revolutions of the four yugas. This time period is called Manvantara, or the age of a Manu, the Hindu progenitor of humanity. Manvantara is a Sanskrit word, a compound of Manu and Antar, Manuantara or Manvantara, literally meaning the duration of a Manu or his lifespan. Each Manvantara lasts the lifetime of a Manu, upon whose death Brahma creates another Manu to continue the cycle of creation or Srishti. Each Manvantara has separate Manu and their descendants, separate groups of Saptarshis and gods, separate Indras and their attendants like Gandharvas, Apsaras and so on. This is the day-to-day creation of Brahma, which affects the three worlds alone, and in which the subhuman creatures, human beings, Pitrus and gods are born according to their respective karma. Now, as we said, 1000 revolutions of Chaturyuga make a day of Brahma, which means 4.32 billion human years. This is called one Kalpa or eon, twice of which is Ahoratra of Brahma, which means the combination of day and night. One Kalpa is equal to 14 Manvantara. Now 100 years of Brahma is equal to one Mahakalpa, which is generally the lifespan of Brahma. So generally Brahma's lifespan is this, 311.04 trillion. Now 50 years of current Brahma have elapsed and we are on the first day of the 51st year. Current Kalpa is named as Shweta Baraha Kalpa. Within this Brahma day, 6 Manvantars have already elapsed and we are in the 7th Manvantara. The name of the current Manvantara is Vaivashvata Manvantara or Sraddhadeva Manvantara. In this Manvantara, we are in the Kali Yuga of the 28th Mahayuga. Well, that's dealing with huge numbers. 311.04 trillion human years is the age of Brahma, which is said to be equal to the duration of a Nimesh or blink of God Vishnu. I hope you still remember what is Nimesh. If you don't, then check this timestamp of this video and try to calculate the age of Vishnu in human years. Till then, give me a short break to make another video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.